Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 10, where we're getting into some of the muscles associated with the head. So we're going to focus on three of the largest muscles of facial expression, and we will also take a quick look at the extraocular eye muscles. So starting with the two sphincteric muscles of the muscles of facial expression, you will have the orbicularis oculi. And all of these fibers for these sphincteric muscles are going to be circular, so it kind of will continue along like that around the orbital region. So this would be orbicularis oculi, and the muscle that is surrounding the lips or the oral fissure region will be the orbicularis oris. So again, I said these are sphincteric muscles, meaning that when they contract, they will close. They'll either close the eye or they will close the mouth. And so these are the two sphincteric muscles. The other muscle I want you to identify that is a muscle of facial expression is referred to as the buccinator muscle. It is going to be associated with the cheek region, and it's different from many of the other muscles of facial expression in that it is on a deeper plane. One of the main things that distinguishes the muscles of facial expression is that they are so superficial, but the buccinator is actually a little bit deeper and is going to be deep to this buccal fat pad right here that helps kind of form a bit of what we see in terms of our cheek region. But if you remove the buccal fat pad, then you can see the buccinator muscle right here. And it's this muscle fibers under here. You'll obviously have some neurovasculature associated with it. Here you can see the orbicularis oris. So it's fairly close, but you can see it's a little bit deeper than the buccinator. And it's very much on that same plane in terms of the cheek. Sorry for the email update there. And it is just going to be anterior to the mandible. Now, I'm not going to have you identify any of the specific extraocular eye muscles, but I did want you to see at least how they are going to insert into the sclera or the whites of the eyes. So you can see, just for fun, you don't have to memorize this. This is the medial rectus muscle. And if that muscle contracts, it's going to pull the eye medially, or your eye will be what's called, it will adduct your gaze or move more towards the midline. And the same thing here for the lateral rectus. It would pull the gaze this way or abduct. So it's truly pulling the globe of the eyeball because of that close attachment to the whites of the eyes or the sclera. All right, excellent. Those are going to be the muscles of facial expression that I'm going to have you identify for this course. And I did want you to at least have a closer up look in terms of what the extraocular eye muscles look like. Thank you for your time and attention here, and please have a great rest of your day.